Hi guys, it's Crystal with Design Bundles. Today I'm going to show you guys how to use Cricut Design Space with your Cricut Joy. And I'm actually using my cell phone today, so I thought that would be a lot useful for somebody that wants to use their phone with their machine. First up, if you click on your little face up there in the left-hand side, you can change your machine. So as you guys can see here, there is a wide variety of machines, and all you need to simply do is click on the Cricut Joy. So now it is converted over to all the settings that you need for the Cricut Joy. So you always want to do that right away so you're going to be ready to go. So from left to right, you can see here we've got lots of different options down below. One of the first ones I'm going to touch base on is uploading your own image. So you can definitely browse Cricut's images and things like that, but you could also upload your image through your phone. So for example, I'm going to bring in this image right here. Once you click on it, you can click insert, and there you have it. From here, we're going to have lots more options like the actions button, edit, and things like that. So you can size this down, pinch your screen to bring your screen in and out without adjusting your size. So let's go ahead and click on actions. And as you guys can see here, these things are not visual because they're not available with this design. If you needed to ungroup or anything, those things would be highlighted in black just like so. So right now we have two options with this design, and that is duplicate or contour. So you can simply click on those. So once they're highlighted, you can use them. So I'm going to hit duplicate. And as you guys can see, it's going to duplicate the image. We can also do the hide contour here, so we can click on it, and then from here we would be able to remove any pieces that we don't want. So you're simply going to click on those, and when they kind of go in like a ghost mode, as you guys can see here, in a faint color, that means you're not going to see it. Now let's go back into hide contour. You can actually pinch in and really get those small pieces. So if you struggle to remove those, just kind of pinch in and then click on them. All right, so that is hide contour. Next up, let's go ahead and go over the edit button. From the edit, you're going to be able to change your color as well as, is it a cut file, draw file, and things like that. So you can choose some of the basic colors already chose here, or you can use this box down below to really customize a certain color that you may want. Once you have a color, you're simply just going to go ahead and choose it and hit apply, just like that. So let's go ahead and go back in there and choose another color just so you guys can see it here. So we're just going to pick this purple and then hit apply again. All right, so from here, we're going to go ahead and once you click on it, your options will come back up. You're going to see your width and height at this point. So from here, you can go ahead and click on this and your numbers will pop right up and you're just going to type it in. I'm going to put in 4.5 and then it's going to adjust the height for us. I'm going to pinch the screen here to zoom it back in, not changing the size of my design. You can rotate it here by typing it in. You can just type that in and rotate it as much as or a little as you need to. Next up, we also have the horizontal and vertical. So if you flip this, it's just going to mirror your design, or you can flip it upside down as well. Another one is the position. We don't talk about this very much. It's just basically moving it over on your mat here. So you can see it's just kind of shifted over. So I'm going to go ahead and bring that back in here. Now, some other things. You see these are not highlighted because they're not available. Well, let's go ahead and go back and duplicate this. And then let's go back over here to edit. And now you're going to see now that there's two, now this is available. For example, the arrange. So you can use the arrange to bring these, you know, forward or backwards if you had multiple pieces. Next up, if you just take your fingers and highlight everything, you can select everything. Then you have the align option. And from here, we can align everything. So I'm going to go ahead and center just like that. So let's go ahead and delete this layer again. So you're just simply going to click out, click on one, and then you can delete it with the X, just like so. Next up, you have sync. If you had multiple colors here, you can actually sync all of your colors. So if I had several different pieces, I could go ahead and sync those to the same. The layers tab is going to be if you have multiple layers, you can go in here and attach them. From here at the bottom, you do have options. So if you click on it, you can actually still hide your design right in here. You can duplicate your design right inside, and you can also delete pieces. If you click your layers button again, it's going to get rid of this window right here. So we're going to go ahead and come down here and just click that. And then next up you have undo and redo. So you can undo something or redo it to add it just like so. And then you have camera and settings. We'll get into those later. Next up, once you're ready to go, you're simply just going to go ahead and hit make it. From here, you're going to get options like without the mat, on the mat, card mat, all of those things. I'm gonna click without the mat. From here, it's gonna show you how big of a sheet that you're gonna need. So for example, we need it to be 5.5 by 7. To get more information, you can click on the mat up here in the left-hand corner. You can add how many copies do you need of this project. It's going to tell you you need to cut a 7.25 piece. You can, at this point, change it from without the mat on the mat, so you can go and adjust that again. And if you're using iron-on, you can adjust whether you need to mirror it just like so. So I'm going to go ahead and change the material size, and I'm going to say I'm actually going to cut this to 8 inches just so the machine knows, and then I'll hit enter, and there you have it. It's adjusted itself. All right, so let's go ahead and get back out of here just by clicking anywhere on the screen. So now we have a 5.5 by 8 piece, and we're going to go ahead and hit continue. From here, you can set your materials. So right away, you can go to, you know, favorites or popular. Popular is going to be what's more common, most people use. You can definitely go to all materials, and this, you're going to be able to see all the materials. You can search things just like so. So let's go ahead and go into all materials. So you're going to have all, which is going to show everything. You're going to have favorites. Now let's go ahead and show you how to do favorites. To do your favorites, you just need to hit the star right here on the right. And now if you click on favorites, it's going to add it. So you can go through all of these. There's, you know, it's got by color coordinated. You have cardstock, iron-on, vinyl, and then you're just going to hit the star by the ones that you're going to use the most, and then they're going to become your favorite. So I'm going to go ahead and scroll down here to the vinyl, and I'm going to search for a smart vinyl. So I'm just going to go ahead and keep scrolling here until I see the one I want. I'm almost here, so I'm going to go ahead and keep scrolling down. So I see the smart vinyl permanent, and I'm going to hit the star. All right, so now if we go to favorites, you can see all of those have added just like so. Next up, you can go to compatible, which is going to be everything that is compatible with the Cricut Joy, and you're seeing a lot of smart materials here. Now, that's another thing. You can actually go back over here to all, and then we can actually use the search tool here. So I can just simply start to type out perm, and it's going to bring up smart vinyl permanent. I could come over here and maybe type in smart. It's going to bring up all of the smart materials. So you can search for those just like that. Hollow, you can type in HOL, and you're going to get holographic. Once you're done with that, now you can see I've got some stars popping up. I can go to favorites, and you can see those are going to pop up right here on that front screen for us. Once you're ready to go, you're going to hit the go button from here. There's no buttons on the Cricut Joy. So a go button will pop up once you load your material. And then when it's ready to unload, you can see an unload there, or it will pop up so you can unload it. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you guys found it helpful. If you guys did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe. And I'll see you on the next one.